Hey guys, we are live here at the Kickstart. Beautiful things is happening. A lot of people just got baptized over there. We have a pool there, three pools where people got baptized. We have just scattered a lot of people here to be baptized with the Holy Spirit. And a lot of those have been baptized with the Holy Spirit. And a lot of people experience freedom from demons and other things at the same time. There is somebody sitting, being set free there. And this is what we are called to do. This is beautiful. So like, seek us set free before we see the Holy Spirit. He's now helping pray for somebody else to get set free. And everyone here have story. You have been filming with me a lot now. How have it been to go around and film and see this?
It's been amazing. I've seen the videos and in person. It's real. It's beautiful. See people delivered and healed and set free. It's amazing.
Now when you see it, it's one thing to see it in video. How is it like when you experience it and are here?
It's completely life-changing.
You love it?
I love it. It's amazing.
And this is what we are called to do. So one by one, want to experience freedom. Like this guy, woo, how is it?
Great,
like
it's amazing.
Yesterday, you had a problem with reading. And
yeah,
problem.
I was a drug addict for like 5 years, heroin, methamphetamine, and I received freedom, and it's been 2 years, and then it was still something there. I couldn't read ever. I couldn't any book, any other book but the Bible I could read, but the Bible I could not read. I couldn't concentrate. I couldn't think, and I received freedom yesterday. I was prayed for. And I received freedom, and I woke up this morning with a clear mind, a clear head, and I could read clearly, and it was just great.
So he came to me, I prayed yesterday, and this morning he came, I'm free. I woke up this morning, I'm free, I can now read, I understand the Bible, I read, I'm free. Yo, how is it to be around and with the Holy Spirit like this, crazy?
Yeah, it's been really amazing. People get baptized, people experience the freedom. We just right now gather a group of people who don't have the Holy Spirit, those who want to have the Holy Spirit speak in tongues, and one by one start to speak in tongues, fall down because they're free and so on. This is life.
How is it?
Awesome! This is my friend Stephanie.
And she got baptized, yeah, and she's been freedom.
And she is gonna start speaking in tongues here a little bit, but we're getting breakthrough.
How is it for you to experience all of this?
Oh my gosh, it's so good. It's like, I live for this.
So, but if I go around every place, there is people like this. Can I? No. Okay, I'm live. Is okay? I film you. Okay. He just got baptized. 17 years. 17 years. He just got baptized. Received the Holy Spirit 20 minutes ago. How was that?
It's awesome.
And now he prayed for somebody 10 minutes later who got the Holy Spirit. How was that?
Awesome.
So try to imagine that. Received the Holy Spirit 10 minutes ago, and then 10 minutes later, he prayed for somebody who got baptized in the Spirit, and there's freedom. So this one God is doing, so these days have been amazing. If I go around, I find people. Can I film you 2 seconds?
Sure.
I'm live here.
Yes.
They came the whole way from California.
Yes.
She was out on the street yesterday, pray for people first who got healed with braces and different things happen. How have these days been like?
It is amazing. We're changed, and now it's a new day with a new plan.
You have seen it on movies and videos. How is it to see here this noise about people getting set free and deliverance and baptism?
Oh, it's great. It's great. We love it.
Yeah, what'd you say? I'm watching, like, everything else is just junk compared to this. This is what life is supposed to be like.
This. So everything else in John compared to this, this is what life should be like. And if you go around, I just finished with a bad day. We have our friend John.
Hey, what up?
Oh, I love it. Having a good day?
Awesome.
It's beautiful. A lot of baptism, a lot of amazing freedom, and he's all over the place. And how many Kickstarter have you been on now?
About 30.
30 Kickstarts. He did do his own Kickstart. He came to one Kickstart in Canada. How many years ago, Nat?
Over 4, yeah.
4 years ago, and since that, he had just been going, him and his wife, and just keep going, keep going, keep going.
We love it. I just shared the gospel with a lady who wasn't there this morning, and we're going to baptize her.
Nice. So this is a little greeting from here. I haven't done any videos for the last days, but I have some beautiful videos. I also just prayed for some in outside Target this morning with a rollator who got healed. So a lot of things have been happening, but we have just been going non-stop, non-stop, non-stop. So we have a meeting more now. We're going to end tonight, and tomorrow we are flying to Florida. And then we are going to have a kickstart in Florida the next days, and we look forward to that. And then after a few days in Florida, he's back home to Denmark. So God bless you. A lot of doors have been opened this trip. A lot of doors. We have many invitations. We have a lot of invitations to California, in the north, south, San Diego, all over the place. There's people who really want this. There's people who are hungry. We have people at this Kickstarter who have been driving over 20 hours. Over 20 hours they have been driving. When I asked how many have been driving over 10 hours, I think there was like 30 hands of people who have been driving over 10 hours to come here to this Kickstart, and people have experienced so many things. So I say this has been strong, they've been powerful, we love it, we love this life. So a big greeting to all of you out there, keep it simple, make disciples, preach the gospel, and don't compromise in the gospel. We need to talk about sin. We need to talk about sin. Jesus did not come to save us in our sins in that way that we keep sinning. No, he came to save us from our sins. And we need to talk about sin and repentance. Repentance toward God. Repentance is a change of mind that leads to a change of action. It's action. It's mind. It's everything. Everything in us. In repentance, God grant us a new heart. In repentance, he write the law on our heart. He gives, take out the stone heart, give us a heart of flesh. Now a new life has started inside of you, but the body is dead. What do you do with a dead body? You need to bury the dead body. The one who do sin become a slave to sin. But the slave is not going to abide in the house forever. The son is. And then the son set free shall be free indeed. Jesus came to set us free. He got the name Emmanuel because he should save us from our sins. So in baptism, we die with Christ. We rise up with Christ. Galatians say we put on Christ. In baptism, we wash away our sins. In baptism, there is forgiveness for sins and a new life in Jesus Christ. It's no longer me who live, but it's Christ in me. And then God will promise to give us a new spirit. They have been prophesied by Isaiah, Jeremiah, and so on, that he wants to give the Spirit to everyone. So your children, your grandchildren, everyone God is going to call on in the future. So the promise of the Holy Spirit is for everyone. And this is what we need to do. This is what we need to preach. This is what we need to experience. So God bless you all out there. I love it. I love this life. Come and join a Kickstarter if you can. If you want to have a Kickstarter in your city, go into thelastreformation.com/invite, thelastreformation.com/invite, and then you can invite me or Jon or somebody else, and we can come to you and do a Kickstart there. God bless you all out there. For you, see you in Florida in a few days.